Okay, right, folks. We learned in last class how to define user defined function without any parameters. We learned how to define the function with one parameter, two parameter, or multiple parameters. But we didn't learn how to return multiple values. Did you learn about it? We are passing multiple values, are passing it. But you returned the multiple values? No. You returned 1000, you returned 100, you returned. That means what? You are returning only one value, right? But my requirement is I want to return two values. I want to return two values or more values. If you want to return two or more values, as you know, function can write only one value, that you are aware of it. Function can write only one value, that you are aware of it. But write one value only, write the tuple. But tuple is nothing but collection of values. What is that? Tuple is nothing but collection of values. Now my problem is, in function I can return only one value, but in that one value I want to write that tuple. I want to write it. Tuple internally contains what? Collection of values. Wow, great. First we learn the tuple and we'll try to explore our multiple returning value issue. Okay, working with the tuple, tuples needed to return multiple values by a function. What is the best use cases of the tuple? If we want to return multiple values inside the function, then we have to use what? Tuple. Tuples are like a list, can contain multiple values. Tuples are immutable, cannot modify values. It is unlike the list. In the list, I can go and I can modify the values or not. Yes. But in case of tuple, you cannot modify the values. We are writing here even numbers is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8. Syntax, are you seeing any difference? In case of tuple, we are putting here normal braces, we are putting it. In case of list, we are putting what? Square braces, we are putting it. Right, even numbers 1 is equal to 9. That means what? 4 I want to replace with the 9. 4 I am trying to replace with the 9. But what is error it throwing? Tuple object does not support item assignment. That's what we are saying, it is a immutable. We cannot change it. Let us create this one. For example, we are trying to go here and we are trying to explore about what is this? Tuple. I am creating here one of the tuple, let us say even underscore numbers. Even underscore numbers is equal to, we are saying as 2, 1 even number, 4, 1 even number, 6, 1 even number, 8, 1 even number. Okay, 10, 1 even number. Now I am trying to see the what is the type of this one first. Type of, then even nums. Let us go and try to execute it. We are executing and we can see what is the type of object. It's a tuple. Now we are saying as tuple is a immutable. First I am trying to read here whatever we have it, that we are trying to read it. Even numbers, then I am writing here 1. What is even numbers 1 it is going to give it? Even numbers 1 I return, what is given? 4. Even number 0 means what it is going to give? Even number 0, it is going to give you 0 index 1. 0 index 1 is nothing but 2 it is giving. Now what I want to do is, I want to override whatever we have. Whatever we have, that one I want to override with what? 9. Sorry, I have to provide equal to. Now if I am trying to do this one, let us go and try to execute. What is saying? Tuple object does not support item assignment. Item assignment not supporting because it is immutable. It is immutable. Wow, great. We understand that point very clearly. Let us move on to the next one. Tuples constructed using parentheses. We already aware of it. Now print, define the tuple, already we learned. Know the data type, already we learned. Next, third one, map the tuple items to the variables. Very good. We are mapping A is equal to string of A. str of a. Did you notice here one point or not? A comma b comma c comma d is equal to what is said? Even numbers. If you map like this, here position 1 will be mapped to the a, position 2 will be mapped to the b, position 3 will be mapped to the c, like that. But see here, let us say I am mapping here a comma b comma c comma d, a comma b comma c comma d comma e also I have to write, or only 4 is enough? If I write, let us say 4, I am trying to write here, let us say even numbers I am writing, then if I try to execute this one, it is going to throw the error, or it is going to do it. What is saying? Too many values to unpack. This concept is called as unpacking. Too many values to unpack. Expected what? 4. Why it is expecting 4? Left side, how many things you given? 4 only. So I am expecting in this tuple also 4 only. So left side number of variables should be equal to number of values in the tuple. Suppose I am writing here, let us say, comma, e comma, f I am writing it. This is also wrong or right? Let us go and try to run this one. What is saying? Not enough values. Previously what is saying? Too many values. Now it is saying? Not enough values to unpack. Expected 6, but what, only available? 5 only. So what is your understanding is, left side number of variables must be equal to the number of values in the tuple. Number of values in the tuple. Now it is executed. If you go and try to print the A, what is the value we have inside the A, I want to know. Print, let us say, A comma, B comma, C comma, D comma, E. Let us say I am printing all the things, whatever we have it. Can I print it like this or not? So we are printing, what we got? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 we got. That's what we wanted, right? Now go back to our requirement, that is called as a function has to return multiple values. A function has to return multiple values. Let me write here define raise both. Some function I am creating, that is called as raise both v1 comma v2. V1 comma v2. What I am saying is, I am defining here v3 is equal to v1 into v2. Then I am saying as v4 is equal to, I am saying here v2 into v1. Now I am saying as, let us say I want to return now 1, right? I want to return now, return v3 comma v4 I have to return. If I write like this simply, let us say v3 comma v4 if I am trying to write it, then if I execute this one, what will happen? It's going to throw error or it will work? Suppose, let us say I am trying to execute this. I executed. It is executed successfully. Now, I want to call this one. Let us say I am calling here raise underscore both, just I am saying as 2 comma 3. Then this one I am trying to execute here. Let us execute. What is the output we got? 8 and 9. But did you notice or not 8 and 9 we got in the which brackets? These brackets are available means, what is the meaning? Even numbers we created previously, you executed and observed the output, how it came. So what I am trying to say is, the return type of this one, I want to know the type of this, if I want to go and try to print here, what you are going to get here? Triple. Wow, great. So can I return multiple values inside the function or not? Directly, no. Indirectly, yes, by taking the help of the tuple. Function is still thinking like, I am returning only one tuple only I am writing it. But internally in the tuple, what we have? Multiple values we have. Function terminology is thinking what? I am writing only one. But internally, we have our logic, and it is returning two values. So I hope you understand now what is happening here. 2 power 3 is how much? 8. 3 power 2 is how much? 9. That's what we are trying to write it. Great. We understand now tuple constructed using parentheses. We are already aware of it. And function with multiple return values. Just now we got chance to do the same example. Separately we created a new tuple and that returning the new tuple. In my case, directly I written it. Call the function and we are trying to print it. We are observing it. That's what the about the problem of the multiple return values that we can overcome by taking help of what? Object called as tuple. Okay, that's great.